Dear students, in the previous video, we have discussed the whole poem line by line. Today we will discuss question answers, textual questions as well as the board exam questions, important questions we will discuss. First, I will read question number 1. How do denizens and chivalry add to our understanding of the tiger's attitude? So, here denizens and chivalry. So, we will go towards the original poem. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across a screen. Bright topaz denizens of a world of green. They do not fear the mean beneath the tree. They face in sleek chivalric certainty. Here in the question, two words are asked. One is denizens and one is chivalric. Here denizens meaning is given, a person, an animal or plant that lives, grows or is often found in particular place. So here what would be the significance? The significance is when someone is living in their area, the impact of that person in that area or the confidence and the support and all that activities which that person or animal will do, it will be effective and there would not be fear in his or her mind or that animal about any person. So here this denizens, it is also depicting the clear understanding that when you are observing the situation, or here it is mentioned in the world of green, in that green world or that forest, the tigers, they can walk, they can prance, there is no any kind of burden, or they will not have any tension of the mane beneath the tree. So this denizen word is signifying the thing which is in contrast with the real nature or the experience of the Aunt Jennifer. And then the second word, that is chivalry. So here the word, it is here mentioned that they face in sleek chivalric certainty. Here sleek chivalric certainty, here chivalric certainty in a sense that they have that strength and power, but they are respectful towards the woman. So this is also signifying, even though they are having that power, strong, but they will not force their own power to humiliate someone, to harass someone, to attack someone. So this kind of attitude, it is reflected in both the words. So here the position or that status of that animal or a person may not reflect in negative sense. So here both the words, here it is used in a positive manner, that denizens and the chivalry, they are honorable, they have that respect in that area, or they have that power, strength in that area. So you can write in any way this type of words, explanation of the words. Then next question, why do you think Aunt Jennifer's hands are fluttering through her wound? In the second stanza. Why is she finding the needle so hard to pull? Here first we will refer the stanza and then again we will discuss. Here, Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her own find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of Uncle Freddy's band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. So in this stanza, why her hands are fluttering? The reason is the harassment of the husband. Here uncle is mentioned. So uncle refers to the husband, and her hands are fluttering because there is no freedom for her to do any creative work. There is no any type of opportunity for her that she will explore her world. Means there is a burden. And that burden of responsibilities and the full of misunderstandings and so many things here we can understand that they are not able to take her in the confidence. Or it is important to give someone time to adjust, but just it is male domination, it is reflected, and because of that her fingers are fluttering. So the line is, Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her pool find even the ivory needle hard to pull. Even the ivory needle, in that while doing the needling work on the test tray panel, it is also, she is also facing problem, because when our mind is sound to do some work, then only our hands or the body parts will work properly. If our mind setup is not good, we may not do any task, any simple task in proper way. So this is the mind status or the psychological analysis of the woman who is facing the problem. Or in the beginning itself it is mentioned that the poem Aunt Jennifer's Tigers address the constraint, means the restriction, limitation or the uneasiness. And this is one of the example of constraint in the marriage life. So here, why do you think Aunt Jennifer's hands are fluttering through her wool in second stanza, and why is she finding the needle so hard to pull? So I think in this explanation you would get the proper answer of the question. Then, what is suggested by the image massive weight of uncle's wedding band? So same stanza. Here massive weight of uncle's wedding band. So here uncle is referred to the husband, and why that wedding band or the ring? It is too heavy, massive weight. So why it would be heavy? Because of the burden, because of the male domination, because of the harassment. She is not able to enjoy her marriage life. So it becomes a massive weight. Then next question, of what or of whom is Aunt Jennifer terrified in the third stanza? So first we will refer that stanza. When Aunt Jennifer is dead, her terrified hands will lie to ring with audience. She was mastered by. Clear? She was mastered by. Mastered by whom? Mastered by the husband. And one more thing, her terrified hands will lie till ring with audience. Audience means the problems. Or that whatever the duties, injustice, whatever it happened with her. Or the social status, prejudices, or the male dominations, so many things, or that orthodox family, their personal norms, or the way of living the life, hierarchy, so many things may impact on her, and she may not get the justice after the death. After the death also, her hands terrified. So here transferred epithet it is used. So here again we will refer of what or of whom is Aunt Jennifer terrified in the third stanza. So here that is the dominating husband. She was terrified of the dominating husband. So here mastered by, he was mastered by the husband, and after the death also she may not get the justice, and whatever the oppressive marriage experience, oppressive behavior is experienced by her. Then what are the ordeals Aunt Jennifer is surrounded by? What is it significant that the poet uses the word ring? What are the meanings of the word ring in the poem? So now again we will refer. So here ring with ordeals, it is already metaphor. So when poet is using poetic device, it would reflect multiple meanings. When Aunt Jennifer is dead, her terrified hands will lie till ring with ordeals. She was mastered by. So here till ring with ordeals, this here word is used, ring with ordeals. And then she was mastered by. So here mastered by, already I discussed that this mastered by is the husband. And the word ring denotes two different things. One is the ring, the engagement ring we can tell. And one is the ring of that the cycle, the vicious cycle of the society, which worked in such a way, means in negative way, that now there is a death of the Aunt Jennifer. The burden of the responsibilities or her indignities with her during her marriage life. One more here thing we can say, all that male domination, harassment, humiliation, that impacted in such a way that after the death also her hands would terrify, and her image after the death also may not purify, or she may not get the justice after the death. So here the ring it is, it not only indicate that she is wearing that her wedding ring or the ornaments or the things, but it is indirectly reflecting that whatever the her responsibilities, her understanding of the society, but the society's views are different. Society's aspects are different, their point of views are different, and that point of views are totally negative. So, because of such type of means, she is the victim of the society, and there are so many girls, newly married brides, they are the victim of such type of social norms, wrong means orthodox such type of norms. They will create such type of norms and then they will harass women. So here we can think in this manner. No more is expected here. Why do you think Aunt Jennifer created animals that are so different from her own character? What might the poet be suggesting through this difference? So now here, why do you think Aunt Jennifer created animals? So here animals in a sense, here she created not the real tigers, she created the tigers on the tapestry panel with her creation. And that tigers are different. Then next what is said, that are so different from our own character. So So her character, it was totally contrast with the animal or the tigers. How she described the tigers? She used the word pride, topaz, denizens. Then they pace. How they pace? Use the word in sleep, chivalric certainty. Means that aspect means how the tiger's behavior. She used such type of words to describe the tigers, but that tigers are not such type of tigers that they will have fear in their mind about the men beneath the trees. Means they are fearless. They are unafraid, and they will prancing with the proud and unafraid. That two words again use. So here, when we are observing that she was fearful, her hands were fluttering while doing the needling work. Her ring means the massive weight of uncle's wedding band. This line also reflects that she was having overburden of the responsibilities and the harassment or the indignities, or she was the victim of such type of wrong practices. So here both things are contrast. One is she created the tigers in such a manner that the tigers will not have fear about the any person, especially the men. The word men is used. And then the tigers, they are elegant towards the indirect way. They would not harass the woman. Means they would have that respect towards the woman, even though they have that strength, power. So this is the total contrasting. And here, what might the poet be suggesting through this difference? So here she is having that type of thing that indirectly from her mind she would be thinking to do it, but in her own life she is not able to do. So she is thinking in another aspect, and that aspect it is reflected through the tigers of the animals, but that tigers are totally contrasted with her own nature. Then question number 7. Interpret the symbols found in the poem. Now interpretation of the word wedding band. So wedding band here, the massive weight of uncle's wedding band. So here uncle is referred to the husband and that wedding band. So what does it symbolize? Actually that is the very important symbol for every woman, and that faith, love, so many things we are expecting through that. But here it is the unhappy, means the symbol of oppression or the unhappy marriage or the constant limitation, restriction. So many things here it is symbolized, because that wedding band, it is the massive weight here it is used. Domination you can use. We have already discussed the words. So in that you can male dominated society, dominance, harassment, or the burden of the responsibilities. So many things is one word, because earlier lines or earlier words in that it is used, massive weight of uncle's wedding band. So we will not consider only the word wedding band, we will consider the earlier words. So you can write the meaning. When you are thinking about the wedding band, think about the whole line and then explain. Then Aunt Jennifer. So here Aunt Jennifer, she is also one of the representative, one of the victim of the society, orthodox society, male dominated society. And here she is also symbolizing that how the oppression or the male dominance affect, and finally Aunt Jennifer, this Aunt Jennifer's death, it is also reflecting that so many women, they would have also experienced the same type of experiences, and because of that they would also done the same act which Aunt Jennifer might have done. So here she was not having the freedom. Everybody likes freedom, everybody likes the comfort, everybody likes the love. So love of the family members, husband, the society, it is equally important. So that here she is also one of the representative that she was deprived of all things. Then tigers. So here tiger symbolizes, what the tiger symbolizes? So tiger symbolizes the strength, power, freedom. And there is one important thing, that is confidence. There would not be any fear in the mind of tiger about the men, and they have that respect, honor about the woman, especially sleek chivalric certainly. So even though they have that power, they are the denizens of the world of green, but then also what they will do, they will respect all the animals, especially the woman. They will not harm anyone. So like that, here it is reflected that tigers are having that free, or the freedom, that strength, power, so many things you can describe. Then embroidery. The word embroidery, it is a creative work. It is symbolizing the creation, innovation, so many means everybody has that creativity, innovation things. So it is reflecting the creativity or that creative expressions. Right? It is totally different in her perspective, that even though she was creative, there was no any dignity or the love or respect for her, and she used to do that work in such a way. The words are like that, means Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering to her wool, even the ivory needle. So here this type of expressions, when we are reading, then we can understand that the expression, creative expression also here, it is symbolizing creativity, but because of oppressed behavior, she was not enjoying the task which she used to do as a creative work. There was no value for her work in that family. So suppressed desires, her oppressed behavior, whatever it is, just reflected in that creativity. That also we can think about this. Then, and so last stanza, especially. So here, an opposite character. Opposite character in a sense that she created the tigers. The tigers have that power symbol, but at the one stage when we are thinking that there is, see, is the victim in a sense, there is a death. But in the contrast, her tigers, I will refer that. The tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. So here, even though she would be victim, but that tigers would have that power, so many things. here, ant is symbolizing that completely oppressed behavior. And one important thing here, we can think that it is the victim of the male domination. And then do you sympathize with Aunt Jennifer? What is the attitude of the speaker towards Aunt Jennifer? So here we feel sympathy. Why we feel sympathy? Because when any girl would go in new family after marriage as a bride, she should get the atmosphere, comfort in her life, and the good relations. Everyone should have positive attitude towards her, and there should not be such type of male domination, or someone should not behave with her in indignified manner. That indignities create so many problems, that humiliation create so many problems. So it is important to know that such type of Aunt Jennifer's problems you may be observing in the society. So you have try to think that the next question: what is the attitude of the speaker towards Aunt Jennifer? So here speaker's attitude towards the speaker, it is also a sympathetic approach. In what sense it is sympathetic? That even though she was creative, but because of the lack of understanding and male domination, she suffered a lot. And whatever she was suffering was reflected in the reflected in her creativity. So here we feel sometimes pity on her, because at the end there is a death scene. Then some additional questions, extract based questions. CBSC Delhi 2010. First I will read the stanza. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across the screen, bright topaz denizens of a world of green. They do not fear the men beneath the tree, they face the sleek chivalric serpent. The question is asked, how are Aunt Jennifer's tigers described? So in this stanza, some words we will find. So here for tiger specially, which words specially used in this? Bright topaz denizens, again sleek chivalry, and here how are the Aunt Jennifer's tigers described? So here through these words, author or the poet describes the tigers. At least you can write that words. You can add some words that here poet wish to highlight through these words. Tigers were brave, strong. You can add. So then self, they have that self confidence. Then why are they described as denizens of a world of green? Because it is their habitat. The world of green is the forest. It is their habitat. And they have that strength, power, confidence, freedom in their habitat, and that tigers would go or would walk in such a way, or they pace in a sleek chivalric serpent. So that expressions here we can notice that they are facing such type of problems due to our own means the humanity using different weapons. How we are means now tiger conservation, so many things are there. But in this poem, reflections are different. Here it is the creation, it is not the real tiger. So, but the creativity it is given, and the tigers are here personified. But that tigers have the different skills, strength, so that we can write. Especially, why are they described as the denizens of a world of green? In this, we only think in the aspect that it is their habitat, and in their habitat, they have that power and their strength. This means they will not have any fear about the maintaining the trees. So in different way, you can explain. Why are they not afraid of the men? So now why they are not afraid of the men? Because it is their habitat, and here word tigers use. So they have their own power, strength to fight against such type of activities. But here in real nature of the Aunt Jennifer, she is not having that power to resist it or to fight against such type of wrong traditions or the dominations, but tigers can do that. So yet strong, brave and fearless, so they can attack if something, some such type of activities would observe. Then mention the poetic device used in the last line. So what is the last line? They pace in sleek chivalric certainty. Here chivalric certainty, alliteration means the first two sounds here, consonant sounds, conjugative words it is used. So this is alliteration. You can guess easily alliteration. Short answer questions, some questions. I have already asked in the board exam that you will refer. How has Aunt Jennifer created her tigers? What traits of tigers do they reveal? Now, first question, how has Aunt Jennifer created her tigers? So, Aunt Jennifer created the tigers using the textural panel. And she was doing that middling work on that, and it was her creation. So she created the tigers on the textile panel, and through that screen, the word here in the beginning, Aunt Jennifer's tigers, runs across a screen. What is that screen? That is the textile panel screen on that, with using the needles and other equipments, she created that creation of the tigers. And then, what traits of tigers do they reveal? So here, what kind of tigers here? Traits, with positive traits, strength. So for that, you can refer the stanza. In that, pride, topaz, denizens, these words are so important. Then, sleek, chivalric, certainty, do not fear the men beneath the tree. So all that aspects, or the ending also, will go all prancing, proud and unafraid, the word unafraid, and they would have that proud in their habitat they are living. But here she is not having the feeling of proud in her own marriage life. So here the confidence, strength, power, so many things reflected. So here, what traits of tigers do they reveal? So in that you can use the word. How is their behavior? They are fearless, they are brave, they are respectful also towards the woman. So many, but they are like a bright topaz. So many wordings are there, at least two, three words you can explain. Then, how does the poet describe Aunt Jennifer's tigers? CBC All India Level 2008, this question it is asked. So, how is that description? You can directly write the words from the first stanza. In that, bright topaz denizens in that green forest of the world of the green. And one more, afterwards also, they face in sleep river uncertainty, or they do not fear the main thing in the dream. At least two lines you can write. Then, what will happen to Aunt Jennifer's tigers when she is dead? So, here Aunt Jennifer's creation would not have limitation. So, whatever the creative work, it is eternal, permanent. So, one more thing here you can refer at the end, that the tigers in the panel that she made will go on prancing proud and unafraid. So there will not be anything will happen to the tigers, that tigers will go on prancing proud and unafraid. There would not be any problem to the tigers. So here what is the question? Ask, what will happen to Aunt Jennifer's tigers when she is dead? Right? There will not be any problem will happen to the tigers, as it is the creation of her, and that the tigers are now in an eternal way. It is the long lasting impact of the creation, and there would not have any problem to the tigers. They will prance after her death also with confidence, unafraid and with proud. Then next, what is the weight that lies heavy on Aunt Jennifer's hand? What is it associated with her husband? So here, what is the weight? The weight, and that is heavy. So here, the massive weight of uncle's wedding band. Uncle referred to the husband, and why that weight? It is massive, massive weight because of the burden, because of the male domination, harassment, or such type of indignities you can refer. Then, how is it associated with her husband? Means after the marriage life, more dominating, there is no any freedom of, means freedom of expression, freedom of understanding, the love, comfort, so many things which are actually important that are not observed in the marriage life. That all things, restrictions, means the constraint of family life, all that things are here mentioned. Then, next question, how are the tigers different from her? CBSE for 2009 this question is asked. So, how are the tigers different from her? So, tiger's behavior, tiger's qualities or the traits, here poet expressed that all qualities or her creation, that tigers are different, means tigers are fearless, tigers have strength, tigers have that respect or elegant towards the woman, and they will not have any kind of fear in their mind about the men, and they are the denizens of their own world or in the forest. But her, now it is her family, means after the marriage now it becomes her family, but in her family she is not having that kind of freedom which the tigers will have in their habitat or the forest. So this is important. So two contrast situations here, she is not having that confidence to live in the life. In contrast here, they are confident, they pace in sleep, sleep, or uncertainty. they can jump with confidence, but she may not have that quality. Here it is expressed that she will resist, or she will oppose, she will rebel against the wrong evils of the society, and she will come out from that, or she will save her life. Here it is, she herself here is the victim of the society or the male dominated society. That is the difference. Then what picture of male chauvinism do we find in the poem "Man Telephone Strikes"? CBSC All India level 2016, this question it is asked. So same here, male chauvinism means male domination. To impose our own thoughts on others, own ideas on others in such a way that their own freedom we are taking away, and we are just imposing our own beliefs or whatever the norms, what if we will fix that norms, ideas or rules, regulations may not be visible to others, but we will say that we have to do the task in this manner, and we may harass others for that sake. So that is the male chauvinism. Actually, the woman, they should also get the equal weightage in the family. It means the husband should also listen her views, her understandings, or there should not be communication barrier, or she should have that equal status. The equal status, it is not there. And in especially the patriarchal society, such type of approach, or orthodox society, we are observing that male domination. There is no freedom she was enjoying in the family life. Then, Aunt Jennifer's efforts to get rid of her fear proved to be futile. Comment. So here, Aunt Jennifer's efforts to get rid of her fear proved to be futile. Why it is proved to be futile? The reason is, when she was facing the problem, she tried also to keep her creativity, but afterwards there is a death of the Aunt Jennifer. So finally everything that it is not the impact, or it is not created in such a way that her rebel or her opposition would create into positivity, because she herself here shown as a victim of the society. Then in the poem Aunt Jennifer's Tigers, what is the contrast between the reality of Aunt Jennifer's life and her imagination? So here, her imagination, in her imagination, she created such type of tigers. The tigers are free. Tigers have strength. Tigers are brave. They are not having any fear of the men. And they are prancing, they are jumping, and they have their own habitat. They are the denizens of world of green. But in her own family, she is not having, means she is living the life as like a slave, and there is no any kind of freedom which she is enjoying. She is the victim of that oppressed behavior, and such type of male domination finally created the wrong thing or the negative thing, and afterwards there is a death case. So we can think that in reality, she created the tigers in different way, but her own life, it was the full of miseries, and finally there was a death. So I feel that most of the questions, whatever we have discussed, would help you for your understanding and for the board examination. So thank you. Listen the video carefully.